So far in our cloud workflow series, we have defined workflow definitions from the Cloud Console UI, but it is also possible to define your workflows and deploy them and execute them from the command line. That's why we're going to use the GCloud command line to do that today. I have a local file here I'm running within the Cloud Shell editor. This file, w09hello-from-gcloud.yaml, contains a simple workflow definition, which is just a hello world. So we're going to deploy that from the command line within Cloud Shell. Here is the command to run the deployment. GCloud beta workflows deploy the name of my workflow here. Then the source file, which is this YAML file, and then the service accounts. I may have to create one if I don't have one already. Okay, waiting for the operation to complete. I'm going to use this command, gcloud beta workflows run the name of my workflow. I hit enter, completion done, and state succeeded. Sometimes workflows take a bit of time because there are so many steps, so many endpoints to call, etc. The state may be active or failed if it failed. When it's the case, you can use the following command to see what's the current status of the last execution, or you can also specify a particular execution whose status you're interested in. With the GCloud beta workflows executions describe last, you'll be able to see the status of the last execution. And in this case, of course, it succeeded. So that's about it. You can easily deploy new workflows, update new workflow definitions with the same deployment command. And then you can use the run command to run a new execution of your workflow definition. And then use executions describe or describe last if you want to see the state of the last execution. That's it for now. Thanks for watching.